Okay, good morning. The subject power system instrumentation and the subject code is EE570. After the first three lectures, now we will go for telemetry. Before this, we have completed general scope for power system instrumentation, that was the first one. Then we completed basics of electronic and electrical meters, their working principles, their applications, their hazards, advantages, disadvantages. Then we completed the in power system communication PLCC. Now we are coming to a very important thing which is known as telemetry. Apart from this, only two things will be left. One is data transmission channel pilots and another one is microwave links. Let us start with telemetry. The tele means long distance, and whenever we are telling this term telemetry, that means we have to communicate particular type of signal from one place to another place. Let us suppose we have to communicate a particular type of signal from a remote place to a local site. Suppose where we have to measure one particular type of signals, or where we have to measure some variables in terms of an input. Of course, we have to give or we have to transmit that things, whatever data we will measure, from one center to another center. If one particular, if the sender is situated at a remote site, then first of all we have to send it to the local site. Now how we can do this thing? This is the type of thing. You can say this is one diagram related to telemetry. You can see over here, one is remote site, another one is base station, which is located at the local site. In the remote site, there are two blocks, as because the radio waves will travel in space. Of course, for radio free, of course, for that, there will be radio frequency spectrum. There are two blocks, one is radio wave transmitter, one is radio wave receiver. We can see over here, they are both connected with antennas. That means from radio transmitter, one signal is fed to the antenna. From there, whatever be the resultant output signal that is coming to radio receiver. In between that, there will be one modulation, demodulation unit, which is nothing but a modem, that is connected in bidirectional way with a computer, or we can say that is a particular console from where actually all, from where all these data will be stored. This RTU is remote transmission unit, and here is the situation of data sources from where actually the data will be fed to computer or the remote transmission unit. So first of all, in the remote site, whatever data we will collect as variable, as some variable parameter, they will be fed to computer or remote terminal unit, and from computer or remote terminal unit, again that data will come back to data sources. Of course, there will be a feedback system. If the data will not be collected, it will be going to and fro. After that, it will go to modem. That means the modulation, demodulation unit. You can ask why modem? Because maybe the data will be of very less amplification. That means maybe the data will be very timid, because whenever we are transmitting this, it is going from one end to another end. So we have to amplify the data to hear its audibility. That's why this modulation and demodulation unit is present over here. Whenever we are talking about modulation, that means there will be a carrier wave of higher frequency. There will be a modulation signal of lower frequency. both of them when will be superimposed, then we will get one modulated signal. There will be constructive and destructive type of interferences in between. That's why we are getting maxima and minima for modulated signal. Now after that, this data will go to radio transmitter. From there, it will go to antenna. Now, depending on the characteristics of antenna, they are of various types. They may be directional antenna, they may be omnidirectional antenna. Directional antenna will propagate all the radio waves in a particular direction. For a directional antenna, there will be antenna power gain, directive gain, as well as directivity. For omnidirectional antenna, it will be of much better. After this, the particular radio wave, now it will transmit it to radio receiver. Again, it will come to modem for demodulation. And now from here, the data, this is the linear transmission. Of course, you can see over here parabolic shape, but this is the linear shape. It is going to the base station. See, the base station is also having the same thing, but instead of computer or RTU, here we can see one particular thing which is known as DRS or data recovery system. That means whatever data we are transmitting, that will be recovered and stored over here. It is in bidirectional with the modem. So, what will be the advantages of telemetry? Some of the advantages, number one, there will be no transmission line. So, that means the data will be passed through ether. No transmission line means you can, we can suppose this particular thing, suppose the sender is situated at a distance of 1,000 miles from the receiver. The sender may be at a very remote place, whereas the receiver where the base station is situated, that is in a metropolitan city. How the data will come? It is not feasible to place a long transmission line of 1,000 miles like that. So for that, what should be the medium? The air or ether is the medium. So no transmission line will be used for that. And it cannot be cut or broken, because if physical transmission line we are thinking, then only there will be some particular type of cut or broken. Suppose this is one particular transmission line. We can make this transmission line in this way also. It can go like this also. So, you can see over here at these two places, we are making the cut, or here at these two places they are broken. In case of air or ether, there is no such case. Number two, faster response time, as because there is ether. So, there will be faster response time. Through air it is passing from one particular place to another particular state. Instead of mobile telephony, we are knowing whenever we are making the call, the caller is establishing the connection with the caller within few seconds. So, faster response, of course, that is one greatest advantage of telemetry. Next, lower cost compared to leased lines. Leased transmission lines we are taking for another type of communication, but for telemetry, it is not needed. So, lower cost is associated with it. Next, ease of use in remote areas where it is not practical or possible to use wire or coaxial cables. In remote areas, of course, there will be lots of hazards. That's why we are taking this communication through air. The fifth one, easy relocation. Of course, from one remote area to another remote area, or say some local area or metropolitan area, we can place our telemetry units. And it is functional over a wide range of operating conditions. Now, this is the very important point, because in this, there will be a particular type of thing known as LOS, line of sight. What is line of sight? Suppose this is the curvature. this is the transmitting antenna, this is the receiving antenna. Wherever the signal is being transmitted from here to here, like this, when the signal is going, or you can say when the signal is going like this, there is no obstacle or hindrances in between. That means there will be a chance to gather an exact amount of data that will be transmitted from transmitter position to receiver position. But what will happen if there will be a mountain or terrain or a long building, all those things will be placed in between. Then there will be a chance of diffraction, reflection, refraction and absorption. There will be four types of things. So if some obstacles will be present, then one chance is the reflection of the wave. One chance is the refraction of the wave. One chance is the diffraction. One chance is the absorption. So reflection, refraction, diffraction and absorption. There are four types of things. That means, what I want to say, suppose if this is the radius of curvature for Earth, here one transmitting antenna is present, here one receiving antenna is present, here one mountain is there, whatever be the signal is going from here to here, it will be going like this. Not a straight trajectory, but it will be deviated. Some of them will be deviated from the tip, which is coming under diffraction. Some of them will face the obstacle, which is coming under absorption. Some of them will be refracted as per the density of the medium. Some of them will be properly reflected. So, I think these are the basic things of telemetry, what I should tell you. Next, how far the data can be transmitted? That is another very important thing. That means, extent of data transmission . This is entirely depending on the band of spectrum, band of frequency spectrum, whether it is medium frequency, whether it is high frequency, whether it is very high frequency, whether it is ultra high frequency. It is of course depending on the band of frequency spectrum. If the band of frequency spectrum will be large, it will cover much and much more area. Suppose the VHF band, it is of 150 to 174 megahertz. UHF band from 450 to 470 megahertz. There is one more band known as 900 megahertz. So for VHF it is 150 to 174 of megahertz. For UHF it is 450 to 470 megahertz. There is one more band known as 900 megahertz, and that is from 928 to 960 megahertz. So we can see over here, as the extent of frequency band will be increasing, there will be much more chance to cover larger number of a larger area. Now there is one more thing that should be taken into account. It will be depending on antenna characteristics also. There are so many terminologies associated with antenna. One is principal lobe or major lobe. One is minor lobe. One is side lobe. One is side lobe level. One is directivity. One is directive gain. One is antenna gain. One is power gain. One is actual height. One is effective height. All those things, band efficiency, beam efficiency, all those things are coming under antenna terminologies. Depending on these particular things, depending on their values, depending on their construction, of course, we can say that the extent of data transmission, that means the coverage area, will be either increased or decreased. Suppose if in this case, this is the radius of curvature for R. Suppose if the height of the transmission, if the height of the antenna can be increased, the actual height, there are two types of heights associated with one antenna. One is the actual height, that is the actual length, and other is the effective length, which is responsible for data transmission, that means which is responsible for this radio frequency wave propagation in space. So, if we will increase the actual height, then we can say we can increase the effective height also. And if we can increase the effective height, that means the height or the distance in the antenna for that radio wave propagation through space, then it will face less number of LOS, less number of line of sight obstruction. And when there will be less number of line of sight obstruction, there will be less interference, so the data can smoothly and seamlessly go from one side to another side. Now coming to the next part, what is multipath propagation? For that, I am just making a drawing of another figure.